Everyone, Rupert here, and welcome to the fifth episode of the Euro Truck Simulator walkthrough series. And if you remember in the last video, we bought our nice white Scania, which is very smart, and we took a job, and that job is off to... where are we off to? We're off to Rotterdam, so that'd be a nice job. Get to go quite a long way, should pay quite well. And so picking up from last time, let's go. Of course, you'll remember we got the 420 brake engine and all the configuration that you can see here. You'll see how it pulls this 14 tons of salt and spices. Oh, rain stopped. That's nice. So we didn't want to make our Scania all dirty. So far it's pulling pretty well. Just missed the lights, that's not good. I mean, it's not the nicest sounding truck. But there's certainly a bit of power there. See how it handles out on the road. Off we go then. Speeds up fairly quickly. And of course you can't really go wrong with Scania. It's a very nice truck, very nice interior, it's just so clean and they just work and are very tidy, and they do pull very well. Even with this low brake engine. Another person with a 420 brake engine there. In fact, actually, that was a very similar configuration to this one. Very similar indeed. So, out of Cardiff we go. We'll of course get to go over the Severn Bridge, which will be a nice scenic point. It's quite a scenic route. We get to row right the way through the UK, and then we get to go off to Rotterdam in the Netherlands. I don't think it's a very hilly route as such, so we shouldn't, I mean, we're not going to struggle, I wouldn't have thought. We might do, I'm not sure. Not as much as that 360 brake Iveco taking that. I can't remember what I took, but it was heavy. I know that much. Or as heavy as that 44 ton structural component that I took with the Peterbilt. That was quite a challenge. Even with whatever that brake was, I think it was 820 or something like that. So yeah. Okay. So we'll just get out onto the motorway, and then I'll talk to you about some things that are going on my channel and outside of my channel that we'll be able to do. Yeah, it pulls pretty well actually. Ooh, that's a nice sounding retarder. That sounds nice, that does. Not sure if that's stock sounds. It certainly doesn't sound like it. It's normally a much whinier. That might be the Peterbilt mod actually. It's conflicting with that because I'm pretty sure that was what the Peterbilt sounded like. I may be wrong. I'll have to have a look at that sometime. Sounds quite nice actually. I'm not going to complain. So cool. The thing is with the Scania, they for me, there are only two options in terms of the interior. There's the Streamline V8, which we can't get at the moment, obviously, because we haven't got anywhere near enough XP. Then there's also the Exclusive, and I don't like the Exclusive at all, so I always go for either the Standard or the V8. I do not like the Exclusive at all. It's kind of a beigey colour. I don't really like it. It's all down to personal preference really, as to what you like. There's no right or wrong answer. There's people always having arguments about Volvos, which is better, Scania or Volvo. To me, I don't care. I think it's personal preference. I like them both really. Volvos look nice. they pull well, but the Scanias also look nice and pull well, so I really don't mind. And I don't think there's a right or wrong option as to which one you choose. Or any of the other trucks, apart from Renault. You can't say you like a Renault. They're grim trucks. There's nothing really to say about them. I won't have a rant about them, but they are awful trucks, in my opinion. So, we won't go into that debate today. That said, they fly well. If you saw that movie thing I made. That's a good fun evening, that was. Which brings me neatly onto what I was going to talk about, and that is... this is struggling. And that is RSL Logistics. Now, RSL Logistics is a virtual trucking company. Now, a virtual trucking company is basically... you basically have companies in Euro Truck Multiplayer of different people who all drive together and paint their trucks the same and whatever. And, you know, they have TeamSpeak or whatever they use. And now I have my own, which is RSL Logistics, and that's the one that I run. There are currently 6 members. You're welcome to join. Now, the joining process is very, very simple indeed. Now, you can either send me an email or find my account on Steam and send me a message through that, and then I'll add you to the company. Now, unlike a lot of these trucking companies who take it way too serious for my liking, we don't bombard you with rules. There's just one rule, really, and that's to have fun and to drive. You've got to drive fairly responsibly. We don't want you just messing around and crashing or whatever, but, you know, we'll have fun, like we did with the Renault video. I mean, that was just us having a bit of a laugh, really. And we just enjoy driving together. So you're welcome to come and join. I'll leave a link to the Facebook page and the... What else do I have? I can't remember. The Steam group and whatever. And then you can come and join us. Which is good fun. I mean, I'm trying to grow it as big as possible because it's good fun having massive convoys with lots of us. And I obviously, the whole point in RSL is that I record the convoys and we make videos of it. And it's all a bit of fun. So yeah, there you go. So you're welcome to come and join. Again, I'll leave the links to all of that kind of stuff in the description. And take a look. Okay, so looking, we have a rest stop in 4 hours. Have to keep an eye on that. I will see if we can get to the ferry in time. I think we probably will, but I don't know. So we've got most of the journeys on the ferry. And there's a tiny bit in the Netherlands. It's a nice truck, it's pulling well, it looks great, and it wasn't actually very expensive. Not at all. So I'll probably do a couple of jobs, and then I think it will be time to expand the company and get some more drivers in. And then we'll be starting to make some big money. These corners are not very nice, actually, because they're very tight and very steep, and quite tight bends as well, so they're a bit steep and horrible, really. Okay, so we've got an ETA of midnight. Midnight, yeah, okay. That's fine, I mean, that's time remaining of 27 hours, 13 hours, so well, we can't really judge anything until we've been over the ferry because that messes everything up, but I'm just going to keep my foot flat down now, keep it on the limiter, and we'll see how we go when we get there. only thing that's not so good about the standard interior is you don't get the GPS built into the dash, which is a bit of a shame. You can just see the black panel where it's supposed to be. But it's not too much of a problem because we've got this GPS. I like to use the one on the dash though, I tend to turn that one off. It does depend though. Okay. Coming up behind a truck, see if we can go for the overtake. That's one thing I do have to say about Eurotruck, the AI has got a lot better. When I first started playing it wasn't bad as such, it was just not... There were a lot of bugs and a lot of annoying bits, but actually they're pretty good now. And if there are any bugs, they're usually hilariously funny and you can't moan about them anyway. And they're two very different playstyles, single player and multiplayer, they're very different. Single player is good fun if you want a bit of realistic trucking and you want to just kind of relax and not really, you know, have to concentrate on people lagging all over the place. It's very nice, just a nice relaxing experience. And then you have multiplayer, which is a bit more where you get a lot of bad drivers and you have to be quite alert as to what's going on and people slamming their brakes on for no apparent reason and whatever and things like that. And I like them both as much as each other. I just think they're very different. I don't think there's a better or a worse one. I do love to go in single player and just kind of relax on my own with kind of just driving a nice truck and trying out some mods. It's just a bit of fun really. And then there's also the multiplayer where you probably want to drive with friends. I don't tend to drive multiplayer on my own. I don't see the point really. I tend to just, if I'm going to go in multiplayer, I'll be driving with all the guys from RSL or which is some of my friends. Or whatever. But, you know. If I just want to drive my own, I'll just go on single player, because that's really what it's for, in my opinion. But I'm so glad that the people who made multiplayer, because it's just such a good thing. It's a really... Because otherwise, I think you probably would get bored of single player after a long while. But the fact that you can just do whatever one you want, whatever mood you're in, you can just play with friends or play on your own, it's just brilliant. And I hope they do the same for American Truck Simulator, which I am majorly looking forward to. That's very exciting. I'm definitely going to get it. It looks very nice. The pictures I've seen are pretty incredible. So I just hope there's a multiplayer for that as well. I mean, I'm not going to moan if there isn't, but it would be nice if there was. I don't know what the community is going to be like for the ATS, whether it's going to change a lot or whether it's just going to be the same kind of people just playing on that, and whether the thing that I'm a little bit worried about is that if they release ATS, if they release a multiplayer for it, whether the amount of people in the multiplayer on Euro Truck multiplayer will decrease as the people on ATS multiplayer increases. Because it's all well and good, it's spreading out, but it's going to mean there's less people, and I like there to be a lot, because otherwise I think it feels very empty. And I would think it... The thing they need to add, in my opinion, is AI. I don't see why they can't. Well, I can kind of see where they're coming from, because it would be very tricky to sync it server-side and whatever. It would be very difficult and probably induce more lag. But I think it's something that people want. Because when you're just driving and you see the occasional truck, certainly in Scandinavia, because not everyone has it, and you'll be driving in Scandinavia and, you know, it'll be quite empty sometimes, and it feels too sparse. There's not enough going on. It doesn't feel lived in at all. So I think that's something that they need to work on adding. I know I can see where they're coming from not adding it, but in my opinion that should be one of their priorities. Oh, got a truck going for the overtake there. I might do too. Yeah. Whoa, that car is an idiot. Oh, no, we've got a car coming in. Okay, I'm putting my foot down here. I was driving from that focus there. Just floor it at the back of the lorry and then swerve out at the last minute. keep my foot down now. If we're going down here, we should be able to get past this truck. I can guarantee that one behind it is going to indicate just as I'm coming past, so I have to brake. Oh no, it's fine. There we go, we're going to get past now. There we go. It's an interesting trailer. I can't say I've seen that one too much, and I don't think I have any mods installed. I may be wrong. I'll take a look and link them all in the description, all the ones I'm using. I'm also, just as I'm recording this video, I'm downloading Pro Mods. I'm going to be doing some more mod testing on that sort of side. I'm going to be doing some more map testing, which will be good fun. I do like doing my map testing, just kind of experiencing the scenery on different map packs and whatever. So Pro Mods is my personal favourite because you get to go to Iceland in the snow, and it's just, I just love it really. They do a great job. It also packs out Scandinavian DLC a bit more, so it adds to the Scandinavian DLC. I thought it wouldn't work at first when I got the Scandinavian DLC, but apparently it just adds it out and packs out the sparser bits, which is great, I think. Yeah, I'm happy for that. I think it also means you'll be able to go on the Scandinavian test track as well, the Scania test track, still. Because you can't do that in the Scandinavian DLC, which is a bit disappointing. So I was hoping to be able to kind of go to the Scania test track on multiplayer. That would look quite nice, kind of going around there with friends. I suppose that could arguably be one of the reasons they didn't add it in, to stop people kind of, you know, messing around on multiplayer. But I mean, they're not linked to the developers of multiplayer, so I can't see that would be the reason I'm thinking about it. Right, okay, so what are we talking in terms of rest stop? We're going to need to stop. Yeah, we need to stop. One thing I haven't driven with a while is fatigue simulation, which is why that took me a bit by surprise. Just sleep. And then we'll be on our way again. Check got our lights on. And off we go. They do need to sort those fuel stations out, because that is horrendously unrealistic to have that length of slipway. A bit ridiculous, really. You can't speed up in a lorry in that amount of time. That is one of my criticisms with this game, is the road layouts. They're pretty unrealistic in terms of junctions and fuel stations and whatever. There's never enough merging space, and there's like these junctions here. You don't get these in England. You get merge-ins and you just merge off to the left. It's not like that. And it never goes down to two lanes. Well, I mean, there's probably the odd occasion where it does, but it rarely ever goes down to two lanes while one goes off and then comes back. Okay. So yeah, I mean, I'm pretty happy with this purchase. It's pulling well. 14 tonnes, I think we said. What was it? Yeah, 14 tonnes, so it's pulling it fairly well. I mean, that's a heavy load to be pulling with 420 brake. So I'm pretty pleased with it. And I don't know how much money I'm getting from this job. 12,000. So we're getting a fair amount of money from it, actually, as well, which is nice. Gonna keep my foot planted now, so we make sure we get there in this rest stop. 15 hours remaining. Yeah. That is something I've missed, actually, is having tighter job times. Because if you turn off fatigue simulation, you don't have to plan it as much, and it's never tight for time. You can just drive and you'll get there on time, whatever. But if you turn on fatigue simulation, it all gets a bit more hectic. No, I think we should be fine, because most of this is going to be on the ferry, and that will then reset our rest anyway, so that's fine. We must be fairly close. Yeah, I mean, we're just coming off now to head off to the port. Just on the M25 ring road around London at the moment. That is something as well. They need to make the AI more frequent, because the M25 would not be this busy, would not be this calm, even at 10. I mean, it'd be a lot more it'd be a lot busier, and certainly in the day it's way too empty. And in the bitch cars, wherever you look in the day, it's just not enough AI at all anywhere. I think really, I think they just need to increase the global rate of it really. I mean, I guess you can probably get mods that do that, but I'd rather have them do it themselves. I mean, why not? I suppose we could potentially then get issues due to performance, because obviously you'd have to render in way more AI. But I don't know. Certainly something I'd like to see. Don't know about you. Okay, so we're nearly at Felixstowe Port. I believe Felixstowe is where Eddie Stobart's main port is, I believe. I'm not sure though. I think it is. I'm so sure someone will correct me if I'm wrong in the description. Not in the description, in the comments. It is a nice looking game though. Very nice looking game. You can't knock the developers. Oh. Another example of dodgy road layout. That's something that they should get rid of. I mean, it should at least show you on your GPS, like a greyed out road or something, but just so you know to change lane. It's just a bit irritating. I'm sure everyone's had incidents at that kind of junction. Who hasn't? Reduce our cruise control down to 50. Looks like I'm probably going to need a break for this. I do like driving at night on this game because the graphics are very nice, and you kind of get that misty look. If you look at the trees, you get that nice misty dark look. It's very nice. And the lights are very nice, the way that they've got hot spots, and it's very realistic. You certainly cannot knock the graphic designers over at SES. AI's quite close behind me. I bet if I brake tested him, he'd probably slant, go straight out the back. And okay. Now these are an example of those really tight ones. If you've got an oversized trailer in these particular road configurations, you do tend to have a few issues. Something goes wrong usually. We are then turning up at the port. Zoom in the map a bit so we can see where we're going, otherwise I'll probably get lost. Oh. Looks like someone's put a pin on one of those Apple maps. Those marker pins. I don't even know what it is, I presume it's a water tower. It certainly looks like an Apple marker. Roadworks. That's not like the UK at all. If any of you know the UK, it's horrendous for roadworks. In fact, actually, one of my friends has got a theory that they don't have enough space to store the cones, so they just put them out on the road, even if there's no roadworks, just to store them. Which actually does sound like there is some truth in that, because you do often see them just kind of piled on the hard shoulder for no apparent reason. But there you go. So that's a conspiracy theory for you. Roundabout coming up. Better slow down a bit as it's a 30 limit. Oversized trailer. That's another thing to talk about. I've got I'm looking forward to doing some kind of big video with a big trailer. So I'll get the heaviest trailer I can find. It's not the heaviest, it's just the biggest. So I want it to be massive and really heavy and just really wide and long. And that'd be good fun. And I'll pull it with something like a Bulver. I might even just pull it with a stock Scania. Like a 730 brake Scania. I don't think I'm going to actually use any mods, because it'd be nice to pull it with something, maybe with a little bit too little power, so it's be quite good fun, I reckon. But yeah, I'm looking forward to doing that. Okay, so over to Europort. And if this was multiplayer right now, you'd have trucks going through you everywhere, and it would be just absolute mayhem. But no, we can just cruise out. I'll remember that we're driving on the right now, and that 50 sign means actually 30 miles per hour. Now this is quite a tight bend, in my opinion. I think that's a little bit too tight. Quite good fun, nonetheless. Got to get your wheel to track it perfectly. The good thing about the Scania, and it being right-handed, that's the even better bonus of having my own truck, is it's right-hand drive. So I don't have to worry about smashing up the crash barrier or the truck, which I would do if it was left-hand drive. Any of you who watch my channel a lot will know that I don't get on with left-hand drive trucks at all. Yeah, another bonus of it is I know the width of Scanias because I've driven them for a long time, so I know if I'm too close to a barrier. Off we go then. Windmills. Forgot to change gear. Try not to wreck the Scania. I'll try and keep it for as long as possible without having to service it, because obviously that costs money. And at these early stages, you want to be trying to saving as much money as possible, like I was with that white paint job. There was the poached ivory, there was the custom colour white, which was slightly different, but you know, the poached ivory was £4,000 cheaper, so it's a bit of a no-brainer to go with that one. Our economy is pretty good, 54.5. That's not a bad, miles per gallon for a old engine. Because I believe this is a Euro 5. Yes, it definitely is. Yeah. For an old Euro 5 engine, that's not half bad. It's all about selecting which gear to be in. We need to get into that lane. I'm going. No, I'm not. Dear me. Oh dear, crunch the gears as well. No. You don't want to have a crash at the last minute. I'm an AI. They do that, slam their brakes on to go into a different speed limit. You don't tend to do that when you're driving. Okay, so here we are at Rotterdam. At this point, normally in multiplayer, it'd be lagging out completely. Frame rate'd be through the roof. And things would not be happy. But now, it's nice and calm. Just cruising in at 60fps. Oh no, nice time. So yeah, single player has its perks. Not doing very well with the lights today. Seem to be missing all of them. Another Scania. Pretty much the same configuration as ours. It'd be nice if you saw other trucks with, you know, lights on them and different configurations, so they're more a bigger variety, because there's no reason that they couldn't. I mean, I think you should be able to see AI trucks going past with air horns on the top and lights and whatever. I don't think that'd be too tricky to add, really. I mean, all the assets are already there, so. Now, I always like to reverse from the inside, because I did read somewhere that you're not supposed to act in real life, you're not really supposed to stick your head out the window while you're driving like this. Really have our hazards on right now. So I shall do it the realistic way and drive from inside. It's all about where those rear wheels are. Now this is a nice long trailer today, so I don't need to worry about blooming short trailers. Don't even get me started on them, they're horrible to reverse. So we should be able to just get this one in M1 like that. There you go. Lovely. Over to one side, but not too bad at all. So, yeah. €12,000, that's not bad. 615 XP, so we're on our way up now. So, we've got 18,000, and in the next video, we'll be expanding and getting some more drivers employed and upgrading our garage and loans and things like that. So, that'll be something to look forward to. So, until next time, everyone, take care and I'll see you soon.